सौंदर्यलहरी कर्त्रे सर्वमंगलदायिने शंकराचार्यवर्याय यतिराजाय ते नमः। सौंदर्य लहरी श्लोक 81। गुरुत्वं विस्तारं क्षितिधरपतिः पार्वती निजात् नितंबादाच्छिद्य त्वयि हरणरूपेण निदधे अतस्ते विस्तीर्णो गुरुरयमशेषां वसुमतीं नितंब प्राग्भारः स्थगयति लघुत्वं नयति च। इन दिस फॉर पदविभाग लुक एट द सेकेंड लाइन फर्स्ट वर्ड नितंबात् आच्छिद्य देन थर्ड लाइन अतः ते थर्ड वर्ड गुरुः अयम् अशेषाम्। नाउ अन्वय हे पार्वती क्षितिधरपतिः गुरुत्वं विस्तारं निजात् नितंबात् आच्छिद्य त्वयि हरणरूपेण निदधे अतः ते अयम् नितंबप्राग्भारः गुरुः विस्तीर्णः अशेषां वसुमतीं स्थगयति लघुत्वं नयति च। इन दिस श्लोक भगवत्पादा हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड भगवतीज हिप्स। हे पार्वती ओ डॉटर ऑफ पर्वतराजा क्षितिधर पति ही क्षिति ही मीन्स भूमि ही क्षितिधर इज दैट विच इज होल्डिंग द अर्थ इन प्लेस विच मीन्स माउंटेन पति ही इज लॉर्ड सो क्षितिधर पति ही इज लॉर्ड ऑफ द माउंटेन्स विच मीन्स हिमवान। गुरुत्वं हेवीनेस विस्तारं एक्सपैंसिवनेस निजात फ्रॉम हिज ओन नितंबात फ्रॉम द फ्लैंक्स ऑफ हिज माउंटेन आच्छिद्य हैविंग कट आउट त्वयि एंड टू यू हिज लविंग डॉटर हरण रूपेण हरण मीन्स गिफ्ट्स गिवन टू द डॉटर एट द टाइम ऑफ हर मैरिज सो हियर हरण रूपेण मीन्स in the form of dowry nidadhe he gave different things given as gifts to one's daughter at the time of her marriage has been a tradition in line with that parvataraja is said to have given a large flank of his mountain to his daughter parvati atah because of that I am this nitamba pragbharaha The weight of Devi's hips is Guruhu, very heavy, Vistirnaha, expansive. Being so, Asesham, completely, Vasumatim, the earth, Sthagayati, it conceals. Cha, and also, Laghutvam, lightness, Nayati, it makes it. Durga Saptashati says, Devi took Vishwarupa when she was fighting Mahishasura. In that war, the brilliance and power of all the devatas was put together and a female form is said to have manifested. The personification of that massive female form is Devi. That Vishwarupa of Devi pervaded the earth, space and netherworld. The weapons she wielded were given to her by all the devatas and her brilliance spread across the directions. Her 1000 arms spanned the universe and this awesome all-pervading form of Devi in Vishwarupa should be visualized to appreciate this verse being described by Bhagavad Pada. It is said when Devi took such a Vishwarupa, शूलं शूलाद् विनिष्कृत्य ददौ तस्यै पिनाकदृक् पिनाकदृक् मीन्स लॉर्ड शिवा इट सीम्स ही गेव हिज वेपन शूलं द ट्राइडेंट टू हर एंड देन ऑल द अदर देवतास गेव देयर वेपन्स टू हर हिमवान वाहनं सिंहं रत्नानि विविधानि च इट सेज हिमवान गेव हर अ वेहिकल सिंहवाहनं And many valuable gems also. Then, From the flanks of his mountains, Himavan gave her the expanse, Vistirna, and weight, Gurutvam, of the mountain. Sri Shankara says, this is the reason the expanse of her posterior or hips, Nitamba Pradeshaha, envelops and pervades the whole earth and also outweighs the earth itself. The words Laghutvam Nayati implies that in the expanse of Vishwarupa, Devi is so heavy that the earth appears to be lighter. In other words, the otherwise normally large expanse of the earth becomes insignificant in the presence of Devi's expansiveness, which in this verse is mentioned as concealing the earth, Asesham Vasumatim Sthagayati. In essence, this verse describes that the expanse and heaviness of Devi's hips is because of the massive gifts she received from her father Himavan at the time of marriage. Now, this is a poetic style of describing Devi's greatness. These words, Asesham Vasumatim Sthagayati, gives the meaning of Devi is Purna Swarupini. She is complete in all aspects. In Devi Mahatmyam, Markandeya Muni praises Devi, who manifested from all the brilliance and power of Devatas put together, as Varunena cha Jangoru Nitambas Tejasa Bhuvaha. Energy from Varuna Devata took the form of Devi's legs and thighs, Jangha and Uru. The splendor of Bhumi Devata took the form of Nitamba Pradeshaha, that is her hips. He says, Bhuvaha Tejasa Nitambaha. Bhuvaha means the earth, Tejasa from the earth's splendor, Nitambaha, her hips took a form. This verse is concluded here. Harihi Om. Saundarya Lahari, Shloka 82. Karindranam Shundan कनककदलीकाण्डपटलीम् उभाभ्याम् ऊरुभ्याम् उभयमपि निर्जित्य भवति सुवृत्ताभ्याम् पत्युः प्रणतिकठिनाभ्याम् गिरिसुते विधिज्ञे जानुभ्याम् विबुधकरिकुम्भद्वयमसि. फॉर पदविभाग लुक एट द सेकेंड लाइन फर्स्ट वर्ड उभाभ्याम् ऊरुभ्याम् लास्ट वर्ड फोर्थ लाइन Vibudha Karikumbhadvayam Asi. Anvaya, He Vidhignye Girisute Bhavati Karindranam Shundan Kanakakadali Kanda Patalim Ubhabhyam Urubhyam Ubhayamapi Nirjitya Suvrittabhyam Patyuhu Pranati Katinabhyam Janubhyam Vibudha Karikumbhadvayam Nirjitya Asi. In this shloka, Bhagavad Pada has described the thighs and knees of Devi. There are three words of Sambodhana in this verse. He Vidhignye, O Devi, you who know the Vedic injunctions very well. Vidhi means pertaining to the Vedas. Nyaha means knower. So Vidhignye means the knower of Vedas. Girisute, O daughter of the Lord of Mountains, He Bhavati, O revered one. Karindranam, Kari means elephant, Indra means Lord. So Karindranam means among all the best of elephants, Shundana, their trunks, Kanaka Kadali Kanda Patalim, Kanaka, golden hue, Kadali, plantain, Kanda, stem, patali, bunch of. Kanaka kadali kanda patali means a bunch of golden hued plant and stems. Ubhabhyam, both of these, that means best of lordly elephants and best of plant and stems. Urubhyam, the thighs. Ubhayam api, the best of elephants' trunks and the best of plant and stems also. Nirjitya, winning over them. That is, comparing with the beauty of Devi's thighs, all the objects are said to pale in beauty and significance. Suvrittabhyam, the smooth rounded form. Patyuhu pranati kathinabhyam. Patyuhu means to husband Parameshwara. Pranati kathinabhyam, that which has been hardened because of offering so many namaskarams to husband Parameshwara. Janubhyam, such rounded knees. Vibhudha karikumbhadvayam asi. Vibhudha means devatas. Kari is elephant. Kumbhadvayam api means the two temples of the elephant also. That is, the pair of temples of the celestial elephant Airavata. Nirjitya, having surpassed in beauty. Asi, that you are. In this verse, one description is pertaining to Devi's knees. Every day, Bhagavati is said to be offering prostrations to her husband Sadashiva. At that time, the knees are said to touch the ground. So, they are hardened and rounded. Pranati kathinabhyam janubhyam suvrittabhyam. This beautiful rounded knees is said to surpass the otherwise beautiful temples of the celestial elephant Airavata. It is poetic tradition, Kavi Sampradaya, in literature to compare the thighs with the trunks of elephant and plant and stem. In this verse, it is described that both in Saundarya, that is beauty, and Akara, form also, Devi's thighs far excel both Ubhayamapi Nirjitya, the lordly celestial elephant's trunks, Karindranam Shundana, and the multitude of golden-hued plant and stems, Kanaka Kadali Kanda Patalim. Significance of the word Vidhignye, Devi, who is the rudimentary cause of creation, sustenance and dissolution, she is very well versed in Vedic injunctions. That she knows and follows tradition is implied by the words Pranati Kathinabhyam Janubhyam. According to tradition, she, Pativrata Devi, does prostrations to her husband Sadashiva every day. Lalita Sahasranama mentions the same subject matter about Devi's thighs and knees in the verse Kamesha Jnata Saubhagyam Ardavoru Dvayanvita Manikya Mukurakara Janudvaya Virajita. In essence, beauty of Devi's thighs and knees surpasses the beauty of elephant's trunks, temples of celestial elephants, and the plant and stems in form, attributes and splendor. As mentioned in earlier verses, such descriptions imply Devi's completeness, sampurnata, when compared to all the objects in the world. Harihi Om. Saundarya Lahari, Shloka 83. Parajetum rudram dvigunasharagarbhau girisute Nishangau janghete vishama vishikho badhamakrita Yadagre drishyante dashasharaphalah pada yugali nakagrachadmanah Suramakuta shanaika nishitaha. For Padavibhaga, last word second line, badham akrita. Third line, first word, yati agre. Anvaya, he girisute Vishama Vishikaha Rudraha Parajetum Dvigunasharagarbhau Nishangau Te Jange Akrita Badham Yate Agre Pada Yugali Nakagra Chadmanaha Suramakuta Shanaika Nishitaha Dashasharaphalaha Drishyante. In this verse, Bhagavad Pada has described Devi's two shanks. That is, the leg portion from ankle to the knee. And also, he has described her toes. He girisute, O Parvati, vishama vishikaha. Vishama means odd numbered. Vishikaha means arrows. So Vishama Vishikaha means Manmata who carries 5 arrows. Rudram Ishwara Parajetum to defeat him. Dviguna Sharagarbhav, he filled the quivers with 10 arrows. Dviguna means twice. Sharagarbhav is arrows which he usually carries. Nishangav, the quivers. Te, similar to that, is your. Janghe, the 2 shanks. Akrita, he made it so. That means Manmata made Devi's shanks as his quivers with 5 arrows in each. Badham, certainly. Yate agre, at the end of the shanks is Pada Yugali Nakagra Chadmanaha. Pada Yugali is the 2 feet. Nakagra is the tip of the toenails. Chadmanaha in the guise of. Sura Makuta Shanaika Nishitaha. How are those toenails? Suranam of Devatas like Indra, etc. Makuta, their gem-studded crown, Shaneshu, on the wet stone, that is W-H-E-T, wet stone, which is a sharpening stone. That is, the toenails are already so sharp, like as though they have recently been sharpened on the wet stones. Dashashara Phalaha, sharp like the 10 arrow points. Drishyante, they appear to be so. The description is, there are 2 quivers with 5 arrows in each, which are sharpened and ready for use. The sharpening has been done on the wet stone, which is in this verse mentioned as the gem-studded crowns of the devatas who are constantly coming and offering prostrations to Devi. It is popularly known that Lord Shiva burnt Manmata to ashes when he tried to delude Lord Shiva, who was in meditation. Since then, Manmata is said to be looking for an opportunity to delude Lord Shiva, who is a Jitendriyaha. Parajetum Rudram. In this verse, it is said that Manmata made Devi's 2 shanks as his quivers, filling each with 5 arrows. The sharp toenails are described as the sharp tip of the arrows. These arrow tips are always sharp because they continuously are in contact with the wet stones, which here in this verse is described to be the gem-studded crowns of the devatas who are offering prostrations at Devi's lotus feet. Now, Devi's lotus feet with the sharp shining nail tips are so beautiful that even Lord Shiva is attracted. This makes Manmata feel a sense of victory over the mind of Lord Shiva, who is supposed to be a Jitendriyaha. Then the mention of 10 arrows, Dashasharaha, implies that to win over Lord Shiva, who is a Jitendriyaha, the 5 arrows used to delude for others is not enough. So connected to this, there is a verse in Lalita Sahasranama which says, Indra Gopa Parikshipta Smaratunabha Jangika. Smara means Manmata, Tuna means quiver, Jangika means shanks of Devi, which in essence means that Devi's shanks are the quivers of Manmata. There is a spiritual aspect suggested in this verse. Manmata's 5 arrows imply the meaning of the characteristics of the elements. Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha. Shabda is sound, Sparsha is touch, Rupa form, Rasa taste, Gandha smell. The 10 toenails mentioned in this verse represent 10 arrows. 5 arrows imply the 5 characteristics which we saw, Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha, at the individual level, that is Vyashti. In the transactional world, Vyavahara Kale. Then the other 5 toenails suggest knowledge pertaining to the Shabda, Sparsha, Rupa, Rasa, Gandha at the macrocosmic level, Samashti Swarupa. This content has been mentioned in Yoga Darshana. Shabda Sparsha Rupa Rasa Gandha are the objects which bind an individual to the world. Object is the word used for the Sanskrit word Vishaya. Now the etymology of the word Vishaya gives the meaning of the nature of bondage. Sheeng Bandhane is the dhatu or verb root from which this word Vishaya is derived. So Vishaya by nature has the quality of binding the human mind. That is, it binds the Jivatma to the samsara. When a yogi remains steady and committed in his meditation on Devi's lotus feet with the toenails representing the five objects, gradually in time his mind will mature and he will experience the divinity implied by each of these five objects. That is, the yogi will evolve from the sensory level to the divine consciousness. Then this knowledge will release the yogi from worldly bondage, samsara bandhana. The word dashashara phalaha is significant from this aspect. In other words, such a evolved yogi with an unwavering mind, having all the senses in his control, he himself becomes Shiva. This is the meaning implied in this shloka. Hari Om. Saundarya Lahari, Shloka 84. Shrutinam Murdhano Dadhati Tava Yau Shekharataya Mamapyetav Mataha Shirasi Dayaya Dehi Charanau Yayo Padyam Pathaha Pashupati Jatajuta Tatini Yayo Laksha Lakshmihi Arunahari Chuda Mani Ruchihi. For Padavibhaga, look at first word, second line, mama api etau. Then the last line, yayoho laksha lakshmihi. Anvaya, he janani, tava yau charanau, shrutinam murdhanaha shekharataya dadhati, mataha tau charanau, mama api Shirasi Dayaya Dehi Yayoho Padyam Pathaha Pashupati Jatajuta Tatini Yayoho Laksha Lakshmihi Aruna Hari Chudamani Ruchihi. In this verse, Bhagavad Pada describes Bhagavati's feet with great reverence. He Janani, O Mother, Tava, Your Yau Charanau, those two feet, Shruti Naam of the Vedas, Murdhanaha is the head. Shruti Naam Murdhanaha means the Upanishads which are Shekharataya in the form of ornaments on the head, Dadhati, they seem to be held. Etau Charanau, those great two feet, Dayaya with compassion, Mama on my Shirasi Api. Head also, Dehi, kindly place it, which means, O Devi, kindly place your two feet on my head also. Iti Bhagavad Pada is praying. Yayoho, those your two feet, Padyam, on having been cleaned, Pathaha, such water, Pashupati Jata Juta Tatini, has become the Ganga waters which is held on Pashupati's matted locks of hair on his head. Also, Yayav, on your two feet, Laksha Lakshmihi, the shining lac dye which has been smeared, Arunahari Chudamani Ruchihi, appears to enhance the reddish shine of the crest jewel Kaustubha, which is adorned by Hari, that is Vishnu. May such invaluable, significant feet of yours touch my head also. The Vedas are divided into four sections: Samhita, Brahmanam, Aranyakam, Upanishad. Of these, Upanishad is last in the order of placement. So it is also known as Vedantaha. Upanishad's content is self-knowledge. Atmajnana Tattva. So, they are looked upon as the most important section of the Vedas. In the human body, all the Jnanendriyas exist in the head. So, the head is the most significant part. Similarly, Upanishads are the most significant section of the Vedas because the crux of the teaching, which is Atma Tattva, is in this section. The significance of Devi's feet finds mention in the Upanishads. Acharya says that the water used to wash such significant feet has become the waters of Ganga, which is held by Sadashiva on his head. Pashupati Jatajuta Tatini, also the bright red hue emitted by Vishnu's crest jewel, is because of the contact with Devi's feet. In other words, Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, they offer namaskara at Devi's feet every day, and Vishnu's crest jewel touches her feet. Because of frequent contact with her feet, some of the red lac dye, laksharasa, on her feet is said to have been transferred onto the white gems which is on the chudamanihi. So, it is said that Vishnu, his chudamanihi, is emitting a beautiful shining reddish hue. Aruna hari chudamani ruchihi. In essence, Bhagavatpada prays to Devi that Devi's feet, which is praised by the Upanishads, which is placed by Lord Shiva on his head, and that which lends shine and color to Vishnu's crest jewel, may they touch and bless his head also. By saying his head, Mama Shirasi, the heads of all the devotees like us is implied. The Vedas sing verses praising Shakti as Namo Devyai Mahalakshmiyai Shriyai Siddhyai Namo Namaha Brahma Vishnu Ishanaha Vedakaihi Pujitanghriye. A look at this verse. Brahma Vishnu Maheshana means the three murtis, and in the word Vedakaihi, Veda means the Vedas, Ka means head. So, Vedakaihi means heads of the Vedas, which is the Upanishads. Pujita is offering prostrations and praying to at the Anghraye feet, which means even the Upanishads offer salutations at Devi's feet. Another verse mentioned by Shruti is Namastripura Sundaryai Shivayai Vishwamurtaye, which means salutations to Devi, who is in the form of auspiciousness, Shivayai, who is visible as this Jagat, Vishwamurtaye, and also known as Tripura Sundari. The same meaning is mentioned in Devi Suktam as Yam Kamaye Tam Tam Ugram Vrinomi Tam Brahmanam Tam Rishim Tam Sumedham Aham Rudraya Dhanuratanomi Brahmadvishe Sharave Hanta Va U. Devi is giving word of promise, Pratignya, to her devotees. She says, I will make my devotee a great person, Mahatma. I will make him Mahadeva himself. I will make him equal to Brahma. I will make him that Narayana who resides as a Muni in Badrikashrama. Also, whether Brahma or a small one-celled living organism, I will attract each and every living being. Such is the power of Devi. In conclusion, this verse describes the greatness of Devi as the Shakti, primary cause worshipped by the Srishti Sthiti Layakartas. Shakti is to be known by Vedanta. Harihi Om. Saundarya Lehri, Shloka 85. Namo Vakam Brumo Nayana Ramaniyaya Padayoho Tavasmai Dvandvaya Sphutaruchira Salaktakavate Asuyatyatyantam Yadabhihananaya Sprihayate Pashunam Ishanaha Pramadavana Kankeli Tarave. for Padavibhaga, second line, first word, Tava Asmai. Third line, Asuyati Atyantam. Yati Abhihananaya. Fourth line, Pashunam Ishanaha. Now we'll look at the Anvaya. Tava Nayana Ramaniyaya Sphutaruchirasalaktakavate Padayoho Asmai Dvandvaya Namo Vakam Brumaha. Pashunam Ishanaha Yati Abhihananaya Spruhayate Pramadavana Kankeli Tarave Atyantam Asuyati. In this shloka also, Sri Shankara Bhagavat Pada describes Bhagavati's feet. Hey Bhagavati, Tava, your Nayana Ramaniyaya, that which gives joy to the sight of, Sphuta Ruchira Salaktakavate, that which is decorated by Laksharasa, lac dye, appearing bright and clear. Padayoho, the feet, Asmai Dvandvaya, to this pair, Namo Vakam, words saying Namaskara, Brumaha, we wish to say. That is, we offer salutations to your feet. What is the significance and greatness of those feet is said in the next verse. Pashunam, for all the Jivatmas, Ishanaha, Lord Parameshwara, he also, Yate Abhihananaya, for the touch of that Devi's feet, Spruhayate wishes for, Pramadavana Kankeli Tarave, he thinks about the Ashoka Vriksha. That is, Kankeli means Ashoka, Tarave to that tree, which is in the pleasure garden of women, Pramadavana. Atyantam, very much, Asuyati, he is jealous of. The meaning is, Devi's feet are decorated with the lac dye, Laksharasa, and their splendor is such that they are a feast for the eyes, Nayana Ramaniyaya. We offer salutations, Namo Vakam Brumaha, unto such beautiful feet. Parameshwara also desires to touch that attractive feet. With such desire, he looks at the Ashoka tree, Kankeli Taruhu, which is in Devi's pleasure garden. And that tree is blessed by Devi's feet. He is jealous of the Ashoka tree because it is fortunate to be touched by Devi's feet. It is said that when noble women of Padmini Jati, adorning anklets on their beautiful feet, touch the Ashoka tree, then it will bloom and the tree will be full of flowers. In this verse, it is implied that Devi moves in her pleasure garden every day, so her feet touch the Ashoka Vriksha every day, and so the tree is always in full bloom, expressing joy all the time. Seeing this, Parameshwara wishes that he too were fortunate to receive the touch of Devi's holy feet, so that he could remain in a state of bliss all the time. This thought makes him feel jealous towards the Ashoka tree. The word Ashoka means A-Shoka. A-Shoka. Dukkha Rahityam. A state of mind free from sorrow and pain. Actually, Pashupati, that is Parameshwara, is one without Dukkha. So, in a way one can say, he himself is a form of A-Shoka. The Jivatmas are known by the name Pashu also because they are bound by their emotional connections with samsara. Lord Shiva is free from these cords of attachment. So he is known as the Lord Pati of Pashu, the Jivas. Pashunam Patihi Pashupatihi. This meaning is described by the verse Pashabaddha Tatha Jivaha Pasha Muktas Sada Shivaha. Pashabaddhav Pashuv Proktaha Pasha Muktah Pashupatihi. Pasha means the cord of attachment to objects which binds the Jiva. One who is not bound by Pasha is Sadashivaha. tied or bound by Pasha, the same Jiva is called Pashuhu. Lord being free from the Pasha is called Pashupatihi. In each and every human being, the feeling of Jivatva and Shivatva is said to coexist. And this understanding is mentioned in Bhagavad Gita, where Bhagavan says, Upadrashtanumantacha bharta bhokta maheshwaraha paramatmeti chapyukto dehesmin purushav paraha. The same is mentioned in the Vedas as Dva suparna sayuja sakhaya samanam vriksham parishashva jate tayor anyam pippala swadvatti anashnan anyo abhichakashiti. This sharira, body, is illustrated as a tree, and on this same one tree are perched two birds. One is Jivatma and the other is Paramatma. The Jivatma is seen as enjoying the fruits on the tree, and Paramatma, who is everywhere on the tree and around it also, is watching the Jivatma enjoying, but is not itself the enjoyer of the fruit. That is, Paramatma is not the bhokta. He is self-effulgent and is self-revealing, and also he reveals everything around. Shastra says the same through more words like Asango Ayam Atma. Lord Shiva, as the indweller of the bound Jiva, is in fact always free from attachments. Yet in this verse, he is described as one who is desirous of making himself a Shoka by being blessed with the touch of Devi's feet. In essence, the Ashoka tree in full blossom is an expression of divine bliss. Even Lord Shiva appears to have a desire to obtain that divine bliss, which is possible only with Devi's Padasparsha. Harihi Om.